Oceans, in parenthesis, where feet may fail.
Yeah.
I was the biggest believer in this song, more than anyone else. And it got to a point we'd record all the music and stuff, and I kept on emailing everyone or calling everyone and saying, where are the lyrics? We need to get this song finished. And I felt like it was at the end of everyone's list of things to do. And I believe in it so much that I was really, really scared that we wouldn't get the song finished. And so I feel like I may have lost a little bit of friendship from pushing this song so much.
No, you gained respect.
You did. It was always on the list of things to do.
Well, it was one of the first songs I think that we wrote. We got together at the very start of the project, and we spent like kind of 10 days locked away in my apartment in New York City, and we just like wrote.
Awesome.
And we kind of moved all the furniture, and we just like set up, and we just sat there and just wrote songs. And this was one of the first ones that we came up with, and I think we always thought it was a nice melody.
Well, I showed Joel, it was at church when he was back in Sydney, and I showed it was just like, show me some ideas you got. So I showed him the verse idea, and that was all I had. Usually I just have a verse, and you can see the gold in it. So that's where it started.
And I guess we sat on it for ages, but we just kind of kept working on other ideas, and sure enough, Mikey's right. So he just kept plugging away at it, building the music. And one night, again, in the studio, under the cement box, I came in one night, and Maddie was playing just the melody for that bridge section. I was like, it's amazing. But like, timing-wise, it didn't work. And then we're like, well, let's just make it work. And Mikey kind of came up with some amazing way to kind of piece it all together. And so he was just building the music, chipping away at it while we were kind of working on all these other ideas. And sure enough, it kind of got towards the end of the project, and we were like, okay, like, where are we up to with this one? And Mikey came in and he goes, Joel, just sit down and listen to the music again. And so I listened to it, and I guess I caught vision again for the song, and because it just sounded so beautiful. And I was like, all right.
I think we always knew this song, like we put Oceans as the name, the title of the song, and we always kind of knew that there was something about that title that was going to be the end result of this song. And so I remember lyrically, Jolly had so many other songs on, just played at the time. So I was back in Sydney with a friend, Solomon, and he's an amazing storyteller. So I was like, can you help me just like sit down and get some ideas out for this song? And he took the song and turned it into the story of Peter walking on water.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, amazing thought, our faith translated in that story. And so we wanted to take that idea and put it into the song.
Yeah, and so then we kind of got together. It was actually, I think, the last day of tracking.
Yep.
And we knew what the song was about, but we didn't have the lyrics. So we're like, this is a song. It's about...
Funnily enough, we sat by a waterfall.
Yeah, we found a waterfall in Sydney by the studio. This is, you know, months later. And the lyrics just came. And it just became this, like the story kind of... translated. I love that, you know, we had a female voice kind of singing. It's just a song about stepping into the unknown, and it's a song about faith and, you know, just raw trust. And I love that. And the bridge kind of section, just kind of lyrically, I just love the picture.
You were like, what about this? And you kind of pretty much spat it all out in one go, that bridge. And
yeah,
like,
it just came from nowhere.
Nowhere.
It came from somewhere, but it was like, you know, you spend forever working on lyrics and you just got all these little pieces, and then like sometimes it just drops. And it was like all of it just, because the picture was there. As soon as Solomon was like, this is what it's about,
yep.
I was like, oh, that is what it's about.
Yeah.
And so that end bridge kind of just dropped, and we raced back in the studio, and Taya, who's, you know, a girl who grew up in our church, amazing girl, incredible voice, and she's crazy. And we're like, look, can you just sing this song? We just want to hear how you sound on it. And so she kind of came in and she started singing, and we were just like freaking out.
Crazy.
Like, and she just sung it. And then she sung the bridge one time through, and then we said, well, can you sing it another time? And this time at the end, just let yourself go. And she started, she would be singing it, and then she just kind of went to this crazy place. But then, like, she'd just become very distant, and we'd be like, you could hear her just screaming, and we're like, and then the track would end, we're like, are you okay? Is everything all right in there? It's like, it sounds like, you know, she's like, yeah, I'm sorry, I lost myself. And she would go to the other side of the studio and start screaming into the back wall. Like, it sounds fantastic, but if you could just sing it into the mic, it'd be awesome. But anyway, she ended up just singing that whole thing one take, and we just were like,
this song was pretty much made for her to sing.
That's probably one of my favourite moments in the entire album. It's just a beautiful thing.
I think that when we were tracking it for the first time, it was when I heard the lyrics for the first time as well. So hearing her singing it and the lyrics, which it's pretty different from what I think we've ever done lyrically. It definitely made me feel like, man.
I feel like as far as like lyrics, I mean, it's a really good song. And I think as far as packaged lyrics, this would have to be one of my favorite songs package-wise. Yeah. As far as like, it's such a strong thing the whole way through, so.